Viewers, in the last episode we have seen the introduction to the trigonometry, the ratios and the basic formulas that you require to do it in this chapter. As I told that in ICSE mathematics, where there is 80 marks of paper, the trigonometry and height and distance carries about 11 marks approximately. So you can say in some papers there is also about 10 to 11 marks that you can say. Anyway, we'll work out with the trigonometry. Let us revise the identities, formulas, and then we'll start how to do the proof that. So let us revise the trigonometric ratios. Sine theta is equal to opposite upon hypotenuse. Cos theta is equal to adjacent upon hypotenuse. Tan theta is equal to sine theta upon cos theta is equal to opposite upon adjacent. Inverse of sine theta is 1 upon sine theta, which is equal to cosec theta. 1 upon cos theta is equal to sec theta, and the inverse tan theta is equal to cot theta, which is equal to cos theta upon sin theta. Now part of this we have seen the identities. So identities, sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Cos square theta is equal to 1 minus sin square theta. Sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta. This one was the main one. When you divide both the sides by sin square, you get 1 plus cos square theta is equal to cosec square theta. Cos square theta is equal to cosec square theta minus 1, and 1 is equal to cosec square theta minus cot square theta. And if you divide both the sides by, here we have divided by cos square theta. Okay, here we will divide by the cos square theta. So, tan square theta plus 1 is equal to sec square theta. And 1 is equal to sec square theta minus tan square theta. And here, tan square theta is equal to sec square theta minus 1. So these were the ratios and these were the identities that we have done last time. Along with that, we have also seen the formulas. Let us revise those formulas. Here, a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. A minus b whole square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. A plus B, A minus B is equal to A square minus B square. Here A plus B whole cube is equal to A cube plus 3A square B plus 3AB square plus B cube. A minus B whole cube is equal to A cube minus 3A square B plus 3AB square minus b cube. A plus b, a square minus ab plus b square will give you a cube plus b cube. A minus b, a square plus ab plus b square will give you a cube minus b cube. A plus b plus c whole square is equal to a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2BC plus 2CA. So these were the formulas that you require to know and that we have seen in last episode. Today I am going to show you how to use the trigonometric, prove that, and how you are going to solve this one. So as with that, let us see one problem sum and we will find it out. Okay, here. So we are going to do one sum. I'm going to rub out all these identities. I'm going to rub out the ratios, as well as I'm going to rub out this part. And let us work it out with the one through that one. Here, sine A upon 1 plus cos A plus 1 plus cos A upon sine A is equal to 2 cosec A. We have to prove that. This is going to prove that. So here this part is your LHS and this part is your RHS. Now if you see the LHS part, it seems to be complex. While if you see RHS, it seems to be simple. So which method we are going to use? We are going to use the first method, where the complex LHS is simplified to bring simple as RHS. And finally we will write therefore LHS equal to RHS. Let us solve this one. Now in board examination, this will be your question and how to solve. So this will be your margin. Here your answer begins from here, answer 1. So you are going to copy down this question. Sine A upon 1 plus cos A plus 1 plus cos A upon sine A. First thing first, you should know the LCM. So first of all, you are going to take LCM. Sine goes here, 1 plus cos A goes this side. Both of them are going to multiply. So here, sine square A plus bracket 1 plus cos A whole square upon sine A bracket 1 plus cos A, here equal to, or you can even use plus. Equal to is better, so equal to, here sine square A plus 1 plus 2 cos A plus cos square A upon sine A bracket 1 plus cos A. You know how this one is been simplified? It is the expansion A plus B whole square, which is going to give you A square plus 2AB plus B square. And this is what we have used here in this part and this part. So that's how we got 1 plus 2 cos A plus cos square A, by using the formula A plus B whole square. That's why it is important to know those formulas that we have done here. Further, now these sine square A and cos square A, according to the identity, they are going to become 1, because we know sine square A plus cos square A is equal to 1. So we use 1 in place of sine square A plus cos square A plus 1 plus 2 cos A upon sine A bracket 1 plus cos A. So now 1 plus 1, 2 plus 2 cos A upon sine A bracket 1 plus cos A is equal to 2 common, so 2 common 1 plus cos A upon sine A bracket 1 plus cos A. This and this cancel. So what you get? 2 upon sine A. So 2 upon sine A is nothing but 2 dot cosec A. Hence, from the complex one, we have simplified it to very simple, which is equal to RHS. And your answer stops here as therefore LHS equal to RHS. See the way of doing it. So this is how we do the sum. So simplest, complex to the simplest one. So you got the answer to the simplest one. So you need to find out LHS equal to RHS. So we know LHS is equal to RHS. But what is LHS? Is it in a complex form? Yes. If it is in a complex form, then try to simplify it into simple manner and try to work it out to the last RHS. So therefore you get LHS equal to RHS. So this is the one thing that you need. Okay, next time we will work it out with the second method.